save 47 cents. It's just like, well, it's not pretty good.
Yeah, it goes into code alert when there's a big sale.
So like I mentioned, I run the social media, so whenever I find a deal on the forums, or from the crack price tracker, or so many other ways, there's just too many lists. At video game deals is what I run. If you haven't followed it, follow it. We'll be so happy.
Yeah, it's on Twitter and has 150,000 followers.
Yeah.
And you run it 24 hours a day almost.
Yeah, I take
naps. That's it. Yeah.
People think I'm multiple people. And I get people like, you guys are so awesome, or you guys really screwed up on this. And I'm just like, I'm one guy.
Thank you. A bot or a script.
Yeah. So like, I'll get snarky remarks, and then I'll reply, and they go, whoa, I thought this was a robot. What is going on? She's like, no, human. With feelings.
Aww.
And then what's the CAG new deals Twitter?
That is a robot.
There we go.
That is a robot that takes, when someone creates a new thread in the video game deals forum, it just posts it. It's really helpful because, like I said, I take naps. So sometimes when I take a nap, like the NES Classic might be in stock somewhere. The 3DS that was super hard to find might be in stock somewhere. So follow that as a backup and you'll be good. And then, not a ton of people follow us on Facebook compared to Twitter, but it's basically I use a program that posts the exact same deals on Facebook. So you might want to follow both, because you might be on Facebook before you're on Twitter, when you go on your computer or whatever, and then you'll be notified there too. Super helpful. Alright, we're going to go into retailers now. Retailer section. Alright, so who here has Amazon Prime? Heck yeah.
So the best thing with Amazon Prime, you get, you know, free shipping, whatever, 20% off pre-orders and digital video game titles the first 2 weeks.
Yeah. Very good. And then another thing people don't quite talk about is free $1 digital credit with no rush shipping. So basically, you want something but you don't want it within 2 days, there's a little button option and it says no rush and you get one digital credit, right? When you do, if you stack that, or if you're going to check out with like 5 things, check out 5 times. Do that. So if you check out 5 times with the no rush, then you get $5 digital credit.
And you can use those digital credits on like PSN store purchases or even Steam codes.
So the example is here, I cashed my digital credit and I got $5 Nintendo eShop gift card for free. Super helpful. Some people tell me though that they get Prime Pantry or Prime Now. I used to get Prime Pantry a couple times, but then I used it and then went back to digital credit. So maybe do that.
I gotta do that now. It keeps trying to push that on. They don't want groceries, they just want video games.
I eat my video games.
So next we want to talk about pre-order price match madness.
Yes.
So Amazon loves matching competitors. Got match. That's something you might have noticed. So
Amazon,
like,
this is going to take over the world.
$30, and then like 2 days later, like, we can match that.
They undercut everyone.
Yeah. So, but sometimes, because of that, you get good savings. So if a competitor makes it lower during pre-order time, when you get that 20% off, you can contact Amazon through email or chat or whatever, and get 20% off whatever the rollback down is. But the default is what it's 20% off, and you just contact them. So this example, I ordered Last Guardian Collector's Edition. I wanted Last Guardian Collector's Edition. Played it, great game, love it. But Target had 15% off everything for 1 week, and Amazon's like, we can match that. So then they brought it down from 120 to 101.99. So then I was like, well, I have pre-ordered. They should give me 20% off of 101.99. And I emailed them at 3 in the morning, because I'm up at 3 in the morning. And I think I got someone in India, based on the last name and a little bit of spelling. And they're like, yeah, we'll do it for you. So I got the Last Guardian Collector's Edition for $81.59 instead of $120.
Nice. And then the Prime, you get the same day delivery, right?
Yeah, I got it that day, my payment. And I got $38 off.
And then one last note about Amazon. There's also a video. You can watch The Sopranos for free. It's worth it. Just a little suggestion.
Okay. So, like, here's an example. So, like, Walmart, they were like, oh, $52.92. And then Grammy Rush 2, Amazon's like, we'll match that. So, I don't think it's there anymore, but you can look for those and then contact your Amazon customer service. And they might, I'm not 100% guaranteed, but they might do it for you. All right, next is Best Buy. So, Best Buy, I can go forever about gamers.
I'll do the succinct version. So before Amazon Prime started doing their 20% off thing, I think the first retailer to do that was Best Buy. Mm-hmm. This is through their program called Gamers Club Unlocked. Mm-hmm. How much is it, like $30 to sign up?
$30 for 2 years.
$30 to sign up, and it's a membership that lasts 2 years. With this membership, you get 20% off any new game purchase, 10% off used game purchases, and then with the Best Buy's rewards program, you get, you know, codes for $10 off additionally. So I use Amazon Prime for a new game if I want it. That way it ships to my house, I don't have to go out. But if a game gets good reviews down the line or word of mouth and it misses that Amazon window, I'll go to Best Buy, pick up a copy, and still get that 20% off.
The best part is it's all games. So like a game will be on sale for $30, it turned into $24. It was originally a $60 game.
Yes, the 20% stacks on whatever sales are going on. So if you follow Cheap Ass Gamer all the time, you'll see, you know, like, I don't know, Splatoon, $40, or
GCU, $31.99.
Yes, that's what GCU is. Is that your number one asked question on the Twitter?
Yes. What is GCU? What is GCU? What is GCU?
And then
it makes me very sad because it's an old program right now. Makes me sad.
Yeah, and one thing that was great, they fixed it, but like two Black Fridays ago, it would stack with Black Friday deals, so you would get the same deals, but then last year, the update, it doesn't work with Black Friday.
And then there's a rewards program where you get points and then you can redeem it for gift cards. That's way too negative for me to get into. They also, like, customer service is kind of bad there. Who here has had a problem with Best Buy?
Yeah, like canceling pre-orders and a bunch of stuff.
Yeah, so like, so you have to be very, very, like, on top of them. Just be careful about it. Also, if you get Gamers Club Unlocked online, it takes a week to activate it, which
I find
the weirdest thing in the world. Because, like, I subscribe to Netflix, and then they're like, what do you want to watch? Amazon's like, oh, you have it now.
Yeah.
Like, that's funny, you get on the
hop on it now, but a week from now.
Yeah. Now I want to talk about other retailers. So,
Texas.
Alright, cool. So if you live in Texas, there are most states, I know California and like some other ones, I think it's New Jersey, Newegg has no sales tax.
What?
Which is very, very good. So like Friday I posted a deal for PS4 Pro with a coupon code for $369.99. So if you bought it from Newegg and you're in Texas, no sales tax, so you save like $30-$40. So keep that in mind when you want to buy a system or a PC or something like that, especially if you're in Texas. Hmm. GameFly, I post a lot of GameFly deals because I personally love GameFly. We just ship out the discs or the cartridge. So the manual is in pristine condition. There's no stickers on it. There's no like some guy named saying like Games Gang on it or like something like that. Pristine condition.
And they'll have like sales every once in a while, just clear a bunch of
inventory. When they do that, it's like, okay, I have an hour. Okay, here's an hour's worth.
The one thing compared to like Amazon GameFly, whenever they have their big used game sales, that inventory goes pretty fast. You need to pop on. Amazon, Best Buy, it's usually like a whole week, but you know, GameFly can be like a few hours.
Yeah. And if it's the. We buy those games day one, so you'll get the day one edition. So if it came in an art book or something, and like that was the edition. Also, they do not use the digital codes, so you'll get the digital codes if they're unused. eBay also, no sales tax in most places. Usually, it's places like Ant Online, Newegg does eBay, Game Crazy. There's a bunch of weird ones I post, but like they're usually, I check if they're reputable, like they have like 2,000 stars or something.
Yeah, with a feedback rate.
Yeah. So you want to talk about games though?
Yeah, so there's a few other retailers. I'm from California. So a few retailers I go to, this isn't always gold, but Target has their clearance section. So just randomly, and like even Walmart, other stores have clearance section. You never know what you're going to get, but sometimes going in, about like last year, their Vita section, they just cleared it all off. You can pick up all the Vita games for like $5.
There's someone on GP's podcast named Shipwreck, and on Twitter he loves going to Target and posting pictures of Target.
We can still find like PSP games sealed, or UMDs, so if you want to watch Spider-Man 2 for $4 on UMD, yeah. Target. And like, that's why I love clearance sections, just stuff that's been sitting on the shelves forever. With GameStop, I'm not a huge fan of GameStop, but usually after holidays where like kids will get new systems and sell up all their old stuff, they do like big like buy three used games, get four free, buy two, get one free sales. I just like going into the cheap used bin section, seeing what they got. Again, clearance bin. For digital games, if you're on Steam or anything like that, Humble Bundle is one of my favorite sites. It's worth subscribing to the email address. There's two reasons. One is most purchases through Humble Bundles go directly to developers and charities. So like Wikipedia, that goes to that. And every 2 weeks there'll be, you know, a Humble Bundle.
It's usually 1 week.
Oh, you 1 week, 2 weeks.
One week, yeah. It's always Tuesday at 1 p.m. Central.
He knows the time. All his alarms are set.
Dang.
I don't have alarms. That's all my brain. It's wired in me. I have to go post Best Buy at midnight.
Tonight. But yeah, so the Humble Bundle tier, it's always usually worth spending $1 to get 3 games, or you can beat the average for 4, but it's great. It's Steam games and you support
charity. The thing I love is when they do Nintendo.
Oh, yeah, really? Yeah. Oh, on the 3DS.
Yeah, the 3DS, and they did Sony ones.
Yeah. And then there's also Humble Bundle Store, which, you know, Jared will post when those things are on sale. For Steam, the big thing are the summer sales and the Christmas sales. Yeah, usually what I'll do is I have like hundreds of games in my wish list, and if you keep games in your wish list, you'll get emails saying, oh, this game's on sale. But then during the major sales, I just like spend like maybe like $50 to get 1,000 games. Another thing with Steam, if you play games, you'll get like in-game items like cosmetics on Counter-Strike or Team Fortress 2. Most of the times I just sell that back in the inventory. I got like a $30 gun in Counter-Strike. I got an Urban Camo shotgun. I didn't care, sold it for $30.
You didn't put it on Lotto and CSO the Lotto?
And then you can also sell like trading cards. So I'll just go through my inventory once in a while, sell a bunch of stuff, I'll get pennies trickling in, but then that's enough to buy like a $1 game on sale. Or I can get lucky with the drops. Another thing is the PlayStation Plus and Xbox Live, there's the games with gold. So every month, the system will have free games as part of your membership. Mm-hmm. You don't even need to download the games, but what I do every month is I just go on the PlayStation Store, add the PS Plus games to my account, click checkout, that way it's there if I want it. Same thing with games with gold.
Hey Frank, I just forgot something. I bet Twitch is really mad at me. What? I forgot to mention Twitch Prime.
Twitch Prime as part of Amazon. There is no better live streaming service than Twitch Prime. It's included with your Amazon account, and you also get free games, free items through Twitch Prime.
One free subscription. Who do you think they should put that one free subscription to?
There's PAX, and then there's also
Mega
64 podcast. check it out Sundays, 6 p.m. California time. What's that in Texas? 8 p.m. Support Mega 64. We do podcasts and things like that. But you get a free subscription every month through Amazon. So support your favorite streamer. There you go.
But it should be Mega 64.
All right. My favorite holiday.
Yeah. Black.
That's good.
This is where it gets real.
BFDs.
Alright.
Do your BFDs.
Black Friday is like, I don't sleep on Black Friday. That's just what I said. Again, people think multiple people. It's like, yeah, I've been up for 23 hours. I need to sleep for 2 or something. But, so here's what you need to do. Prepare for Black Friday. So CAG on the forums, someone this year is a guy named Ferrari Racer. Shouts out because that was an awesome thread.
Hey, it's also an awesome username. He drives a Ferrari now because he used cheap ass gamer and he saves so much money.
Two different people made spreadsheets on CAG. So this is what it is, it's a spreadsheet. And like green is the best deal, yellow is kind of okay, and red is like,
don't even enter the shop.
Yeah.
But like that deal is usually put together like 2 weeks before Black Friday.
Yeah,
in November, the weekly ads will start coming out and people build this.
Yeah. Just watch out for Circus City when I see you.
Oh yeah.
City. Oh my gosh.
But you prepare. Next is be alert. Black Friday deals go online at Wednesday night.
Yeah, like it's earlier every year.
No, this is, Steam Yeah, it's just a nightmare. It's like mentioning someone going, like, you were a NAM, it's like,
yeah. I remember it was like around December 20th, and Jared on Twitter posted, all right, Black Friday stuff is over, I can go to sleep. Yeah. Christmas is done.
Yeah. So, it's usually when, like, GameStop, Walmart, Best Buy, Amazon, they throw up all their stuff Wednesday night, like that. Black Friday 3DS, that's sitting there, it went up 6 p.m. Wednesday night on Amazon, lasted 1 hour.
Yeah. Yeah. He's like, I got it.
Amazon was like, okay, we're done. So that's a good thing. So once you should have everything, right, by then. So then the switch goes off, you're done, but like you want to go shopping, maybe you want to go to the store, don't. as you can see, there's huge crowds and everything. What I do is I spend Thanksgiving with my family on Thursday. I don't know, it's kind of weird. I'm weird like that. But just think back, show up at like 11 p.m. midnight or whatever, and this is me taking pictures of my local Walmart. Oh, look, the games are still there. Because people want toasters. And
yeah, people are camping outside for like the HD TVs or whatever. I just want to get WWE 2K16 for $5. So I'll wait.
Nice.
I'll come in at midnight. Don't care for that. And another thing with Black Friday, if you're going to physical stores, be nice to retailers. As you can see from Jared, it's super stressful. Be nice.
So many people are angry all the time. This is sold out. Okay. What am I supposed to like? It's sold out after you posted it in 2 minutes. Okay. Alright.
Sorry?
So then, next I want to talk about yard sales. I personally love going to yard sales.
Yeah, I only say it at my computer. But, yard sales, talk about your experiences here.
So first is prepare. Go Facebook is a great thing. Just type in your, whatever your town is. So if you live in San Antonio, type in San Antonio yard sales, garage sales. You'll find groups, join the group, and then people will go like, hey, here's my garage sale, and they'll take pictures of what they got, and they might have video games, or if you're looking for something else, whatever. Craigslist, another place to go on, same deal, and yardsales.net.
And there's like a few apps like OfferUp, or like some garage sale apps, same thing.
Yeah. The other thing is go to Rich Neighborhoods first, here on go to Rich Neighborhoods.
Yes.
First. This is kind of self-explanatory. If you're rich, you don't really care about the price of the PS3 you bought 5 years ago. You just want to get rid of it.
Yeah.
I have three good tips. One is always ask if they have video games. Two is, I'm going to give an example. Okay, see that stack of NES games? That was $25. What I did is I went to yard sale. It wasn't in a bad neighborhood. I came up, I looked around, I saw a guy that was like 25, 26. I came up to him and go, do you have any video games? He's like, last year I had 3 NESs, a bunch of games. And then the girl right next to him goes, yeah, we still have one in that tub. We have a bunch in that tub. And he's like, we do? Yeah. So it wasn't even put out on display. He takes this huge tub, lifts it open, there are all those games. And I go, would it take 20 for him? And he goes, 25. I'm like, here you go.
Kind of transaction.
He's like, something might not work. I got them all to work.
Oh, yeah.
They all work. So there's 3 tips for yard sales. And also never go, there will be like months where like I don't find hardly anything. But you just gotta keep going. So last year I brought like Jabba the Hutt playsets because I got them at a yard sale. Like, oh, that's another thing I got. Like I got Super Nintendo, Smart Brothers 3, He-Man Puzzle, and Atlantis for $21. You know, there are great deals out there at yard sales. People want to get rid of their stuff.
Yeah.
They don't want to keep their stuff.
Find them
just
on
say
books,
how much for all
them.
Of it. You don't want to pick, don't go through and pick and choose. And that also makes people weary that they think like, oh, you got the one thing.
Yeah,
that's worth something.
Yeah, you want to get in and out fast.
Yeah.
And then same thing with yard sales. I don't do yard sales, but I will go to like Goodwill, Salvation Army, thrift stores. I just like peeking in, see what you get. Sometimes, yeah, you can find good stuff.
Yep. All right, now I want to talk about price mistakes and glitches. So there are so many. Like, I was going through like the ones I got, and like turned out all of them were Xbox One. I was like, okay. So back in, right before E3, I was a little nervous, like seeing like the Tesla like track or something. But Fallout 4 was free on Xbox One for about 2 hours.
Yeah.
The Visual Deluxe $100.
With like all the DLC and everything.
Wow. Yeah.
So I posted it.
Called it.
And like a few people whisper about it, and then Jared will blast them. You know, burn. Yeah. He gives it to the people.
It's like each morning. Burn. Here come the horns.
Summers are slammed.
Yeah.
I can crack
clips.
Yeah.
I will crack clips.
No.
I'm not lying. There will be like little niche websites like DonateGamer.com or something like that. And it's just like, oh, okay, so DonateGamer has a black price, you'll post it. Oh,
there was a crash. Yeah.
But you give them so many sales that they can make up or pay back their enormous bandwidth bill.
Sure, it works out. So yeah, so people get mad at me when I post these, but the thing is retailer has the choice to sell to you. So what happened with Fallout 4 is Microsoft was like, no, you don't get it. But then they gave everybody $10 in digital credit, which I'm like, oh cool. I already own Fallout 4, I haven't seen the past. So I don't really care regardless, my guy, and I was like, oh, $10. Pinball FX 2K.
Yeah, same thing. Even if I have physical copies, as soon as if digital stuff goes on sale for your PS Plus, like, we'll grab it too.
Yeah, and then someone on CAG is like, this was a week after Forza Horizon came out, and they're just like, Target has the digital version for $20 for some reason. And I was like, again, I'm in my arm. Burn!
And
it's
been a blast.
And Twitter feed is weak. And, it took Target like 2 hours to figure out what was going on. And then some people got in on it, and other people's server got canceled. But like I said, they cancel it, don't be mad. Be mad that they didn't get the deal, don't be mad at the retailer.
Yeah, yeah.
They screwed up, you know, that's how it is. Another example is Groupon subbed went wrong in their system, and they're discount was $20, so I got Xbox Live Gold for $25.
That's great.
Yeah. Wow.
Screwed up. And then a guy I called Mr. XD.
Oh, yeah.
He's embarrassed for this. He's just like, don't use my name. But I think you guys can figure out his name, what his name, who it is. Amazon had a thing where it was you get a free Xbox One game, and Target also did the deal, but they screwed up. And people were like deleting the game and then getting an Xbox One for that much. This thing that screwed up was you put the Recore Collector's Edition on there, so you got the Recore Collector's Edition and an Xbox One S for $182.82.
Nice. Dang. Like, I'm apology, best game, get on this.
It's also why I'm afraid of going to sleep.
I like this book.
A really common price mistake that happens a lot is like when games first go on Amazon websites, the premium edition will be listed as the original edition.
Yeah.
Like most recently, you got the King of Fighters Burn the Fight edition for like on Best Buy that was listed as the regular edition. So I got the deluxe edition for $47. It happens constantly.
$47.
There you go.
I have to do the right price, or else I'll get 5 people that go, that's the wrong price, you idiot. Which I'm like, okay, you're welcome.
Exactly.
Yeah. I have a Mass Effect Andromeda Digital Deluxe version, the same thing happened. I got it on that 47. Also, a lot of these retailers are completely in the dark, which happened. We didn't know what a Master's Edition was. It said Wii U.
Oh, wow, yeah, that was Zelda, right?
Yeah. Anybody play that? No, no, get later conversation.
Oh, okay.
And now it's completely gone. And now YouTubers are like, hey, yes. We're giving my kid. Yeah, like, famous YouTubers that were at the Nintendo Switch event in New York City were hitting me up. And I'm like,
they missed out. It went on sale when they were at the event.
Like, you missed it.
Sorry.
But yeah, so when stuff goes live, we don't know what's now, what's going on. Especially lately, like, there are so many different. It used to be back in the day, like, everything was $60.
Yeah, just flat.
Mm-hmm. And now everything is like, you think this is a $30 game? Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, because all the, like, Xbox Live Arcade titles, digital titles, Steam titles, that's just a total fluctuates.
Yeah, I went and saw Rhyme Ring.
Yeah, Rhyme.
And I asked them about that, and they were like, yeah, GameStop screwed up. But no, that's not the right price. But okay, when will Switch pre-orders be open so I can tell people about $23.99 Switch pre-orders? Because when I put up PS4 and Xbox One, people said, where are the Switch pre-orders? And they go, we don't know yet. Yeah, I'm in trouble with the person. I'm like, okay, cool. But I'm like, here's my email. Tell me if I can do the car, so I can tell them.
In summary, some other general things with Cheap Ass Gamer getting games cheap. I have a huge backlog of games because I buy stuff so cheap. So a general thing, if I'm not dying to play a certain game, I'll just wait like a month and it'll drop to 40. Wait like 3 months and it'll be 20. Mm-hmm. There's so many games in the marketplace, which is fantastic. There's so much to play. But because of that, working with like publishers, like stuff drops down in price fast. So you just wait, or like when all the big quality titles come out, wait for Black Friday and get stuff so much cheaper.
I wanted to give the guy who had a family before his made Battle Born.
Oh yeah. Yeah, like when competing
titles. When I put out Price Drops, like people were asking me about it.
Yeah, because almost
I'm afraid of putting No Man's Sky.
Oh, Jordan.
Okay. Open it up.
No Man's Sky.
Yeah. Stuff drops, but sometimes it's good. Like when Titanfall, Call of Duty, Battlefield 1 came out the same week, Titanfall was the first one to drop in price. I grabbed it. I loved it. It's just a Titanfall 2. It's a great game.
Oh, yeah.
And then another thing, it's a little minor thing. Hey, if you got friends, borrow their games for free.
That's true.
No, I don't
play. Yeah.
What happens is you play the game and you never buy it.
That's all their panels, buying physical editions that go out, stocks.
Yeah, go grab it. The Gravity Rush remaster for PS4
shot
up so high in price because Amazon was the only place you could buy it. They went over out of stock after a year, and now it's $130 and the game came out last year, and it dropped down to like $18.
Yeah.
And now people were just like, I gotta have this game now for some reason. It's just crazy. So we'll show some information for all Mega 64 at Mega 64. Have video game deals, that's my job. Follow up, please. Characterize with character deals. Frank himself is Frank Howley. I'm 4Long3. Facebook is facebook.com/cheapassgamer. Mega 64 is facebook.com/mega64.
And one other thing to plug is I do a video game talk show called Neighborhood Game Club, plug in again. I did a long interview with Jared, specifically about Cheapass Gamer.
Yeah, we were at E3. Tired.
Yeah, we did an E3 podcast about it. But yeah, check out Neighbor Game Club and Cheap Ass Gamer.
Yep. So now we're going to do raffles. So what is the raffle tonight?
Yeah, this is the best deal here.